Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel Practice CSS. So in this video I'm going to talk about that what is float in CSS and how the floats works. So in the previous video we have already covered the concept of overflow, that what is overflow and what are the types of overflow and how can we implement overflow in CSS. So in this video we are going to talk about the float, what is the float property and how does it works and where we have to implement the float and in which cases we have to use float. So before starting the video I request you guys to please subscribe my YouTube channel so you never miss any kind of update from my side. So let's get started, and the first thing we are going to do is we have to create a folder that is named as CSS. So this one is HTML and it's deleted. So we have to create a folder named as CSS. After that we have to open our Visual Studio Code editor. I have opened it. Then you have to click on file and you have to go on open folder. Okay, then you have to locate your destination. There is desktop. That's it. And here we have to create an index file. I am going to create it index.html. Using IntelliSense, we have to put the initial tags and the title. We have to and float. So let's get started. First we are going to graphically see that what really the float is and how does it works. So let's suppose you have written a divider property div. You have designed three dividers. So when you write the div tag in the same line or skipping the one line, you will see that the new divider every time you create will be not in the same line. It will not create it in the same line like this. It is always created in the next line. So what should you do? That the divider will be created in this line as this, okay? So like this, what should you do? So for this one you have to implement the float property. So all the dividers you want to keep in the same line, you can align them in the same line. You won't need them in the next line. So let's get started. This is the simplest concept I have defined you. So I'm going to open the editor. Okay, so div, okay, now I'm writing its background style. Background color is equal to, I will give it black color and I will give it height as well. Height is equal to 250. We are going to make a square divider. Okay, so let's see that how the things are working. So we will reveal in the file explorer and we are going to open it. So you will see that a divider will be created. Now what if I create a second div, and we have to go to the line number 2 here and red. So you will now see that it will move toward the second line. It will not create it in the parallel line. Or for your clarity, I can also assign this one. If you are thinking that it might work, then I can assign this divider on the same line for your clarification. It will give us the same result because the float property is not implemented on this divider and it is acting as its default behavior, and its default behavior is that that every new divider will be pushed to the new line. The dividers, every time you create a new divider, it will not be assigned in the same line. Every time it is implemented and assigned to the new line. So for getting rid of this problem, CSS have a property name as float. So I want the red divider to be float to the left of this divider. So I will just add a property of float in the second divider, and I will left float left. So you will see, okay, we have to put float here too. Float left. So you will see that this one is floated to the left one. You have to remember one thing, that the initial position of that line should, initial div or initial object of that line should have the float property, so that we can assign the float property to the rest one too. If the initial one doesn't have the float property, then the next we have assigned will not work. As I have done a few seconds ago, it wasn't working because I haven't assigned the float property to the black one. So now I have assigned a float property to the black one as well as to the red one. So now the float is working. Float means that it is derived from the boat. Just like a boat float and float, when a boat is placed, so, or we can say when a boat is anchored, so it is floated. So that's all from the today video. This is very important concept of CSS. Hope you guys like the video, and if you like the video, please subscribe my YouTube channel and do share my videos, and please leave